use the term freaks. Any freaks who are running loose are illegal.
I don't want to hide anymore.
Let me tell you a story. 4 years ago, I was looking to escape some good old LA heat by watching a movie. Nothing was really jumping out at me and interesting until I noticed a film I had never heard of called Snowpiercer. I watched the trailer for it, and 30 minutes later, I was in the theater. And 2 hours and 6 minutes after that, my favorite movie of 2014 ended. Flash forward to a few days ago when I awoke to a 100 degree September in LA, and after thinking I'd take life on that train if it meant never having to wake up in a sweat, I saw something called Freaks and checked out the trailer, and 30 minutes later, I was in the theater. And 1 hour and 44 minutes later, one of my favorite films of 2019 ended. And just for the record, my other favorite movies of 2019 so far have included... And with that overly long prologue out of the way, Freaks is a great movie that I'm truly worried not enough people are gonna see. It's only in 100 or so theaters right now. It's from a director making his feature debut after spending years making tons of TV and short films. It stars Emile from all those movies you never saw, and Bruce Dern, who can certainly be a draw for certain audiences, but I'm not sure how many Bruce Dern stans are big on the X-Men movies. By the way, Freaks is X-Men meets Hannah meets Room. Freaks opens with a little girl living with her father in a dilapidated house. They're going about a daily routine as we, the audience, settle into this interesting and scary new world. Things are happening outside the house we do not understand yet. And the state of the house implies that some great upheaval has upset this world, as there's no power and the windows have been completely covered and taped shut. These two characters constantly talk about acting normal and hiding the fact that they're abnormal. The father bleeds from his eye and demands Chloe tell him if her eyes ever bleed. There's a creepy Bruce Dern ice cream man in front of Chloe's house every day, and every night she has horrific dreams while her father seems to never sleep for fear of the bad guys getting Chloe and he. And all of this is given to the audience as the father teaches Chloe. Everything we know about this world comes from what she knows as she learns it, giving the whole story an ominous and yet pseudo fairy tale-ish vibe as we see this world through the eyes of a 7-year-old. The decision for the scope of the story in the world to start so small and relatable allows us to really get settled in and comfortable before things get crazy and, goddamn, let me tell you guys, the ending of this movie is insane. Just straight up out there bonkers, but in all the most beautiful ways imaginable. It's a completely epic CGI action-packed spectacle on par with most major superhero movies, but also infinitely more satisfying than most of them because of the journey that we've gone on with this father and daughter. But also, it's not all just about the journey, because the action itself in this little indie film is super clever, exciting, tense, and rather funny. I don't want to give away too much because a lot of the fun I had with this movie was going in only knowing that it was more or less an indie version of the X-Men, but I really want to stress how much movie is in this movie set almost entirely in one house. Imagine 10 Cloverfield Lane, but instead of aliens at the end, it's X-Men Days of Future Past, but cooler? And sorry, I really don't like explaining movies in terms of other movies, but again, I'm trying to be vague here because of the fun mystery box ride that is Freaks. I don't want to spoil anything here. Though I am a little worried I may be overhyping this a bit, and if I did and someone ended up kind of meh about Freaks because of me, I'm sorry, that's entirely my bad. I'm sorry. I just got a little carried away here because I haven't made a video in 6 months and I'm just having a lot of fun here. But on the other hand, I haven't made a video in 6 months. That's how good Freaks is. So I'm going out of my way to make sure that people see Freaks one way or the other. I'm lightning rodding this one right here with my whopping 319 subscribers. So, okay, maybe not a lightning rod as much as a sneezing Pikachu rod. I mean, and of course, thank you to everyone who does watch my silly little video creations. I owe each and every one of you a drink. Thank you so much. I'm just having some fun at my expense here, that's all. So I know that the YouTube algorithm is gonna bury this video, so its views are gonna be pretty low even for me. But if you have seen Freaks and you're watching this video, please hit me up in the comments down below or on Twitter at LindseyPank, because I wanna talk about this one, guys. It's so good! And hopefully I will be talking about it this week on my podcast, Show Business, on iTunes and Podbean, your weekly breakdown of the box office, new releases, and movie news. Okay, so I shilled for the movie, my podcast, I'm sneaking in some Avengers footage so the mouse will be happy. All right, yeah, I'm good. Peace out, guys.